Morning friends, today we'll learn acoustic, that is the physics subject, and in that category we will understand first the introduction of waves. So first, to understand the acoustic, the meaning of acoustic is to hear. The meaning of acoustic is to hear. That means we are talking about sound which we can hear. That means it is related to audible sound, a sound which we can hear. The physics of such sound is termed as acoustics. And as you know, the sound and light are the example of waves. So first, in order to understand the acoustic, we should first understand what is the wave, how waves are generated, what are the properties of waves, and things like that. So, what is wave? To understand what is wave means, we'll take one example, practical example. Let's say we are throwing a stone into pond. Throwing a stone into pond. So when you throw a stone into the pond, you will notice that a ripple is generated, and the diameter of this ripple is keeps on increasing as time increases. So we are saying that something is moving, that we can visually see that something is moving from the point of disturbance where we have thrown the stone. So what actually is moving? Because if you put a wood piece on the pond, surface of the pond, you will notice that when the waves are moving and it passes by the wood piece oscillates. It do not move along with the waves. That means medium particles are not moving away from the disturbance. But something is moving, that we see. So what is moving actually? In the case of above example, what is moving? This is a question. So we are generally saying that wave is moving. That's okay. But then waves means what? What physical quantity is actually moving? So essentially it is an energy. Energy is moving in the form of a wave. And that energy we are seeing physically, that it is moving from the point of disturbance, away from the point of disturbance. So in the case of above example, essentially it is an energy which is moving away from point of disturbance. But from where this energy comes? The next question is, from where this energy comes? So that energy is coming from the kinetic energy of stone. What we have thrown into the pond, that particular stone, it has certain kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy of stone converts into
wave energy.
And that energy we are seeing physically. Now when you say the waves are generated or
waves are produced,
then the question is, in which condition waves will be produced? Suppose if I change the example slightly, instead of having a pond which is a pure water, now I add dust particle or mud, so medium becomes little bit thick. Then I will repeat the experiment. In that muddy situation, I will repeat the experiment. I am throwing the same stone again. What you will observe? You will observe that the waves are not generated, ripples are not formed. Why? That means now the system response is changed. The previous condition, the pond without mud was able to produce wave. Now when you add the mud, the medium property is changed, and the same medium which with mud is unable to produce wave. That means oscillations are not occurring. So in order to produce wave, oscillations are bound to occur. That means medium particle should oscillate around some mean position. If it is able to produce a wave, then medium particle should produce oscillation. So such characteristic medium particle must have. That means characteristic of medium. If the medium is elastic, then there is a possibility, then once you disturb the one of the particle of the medium, then it will regain its position, and because of inertia the motion will overshoot and oscillation will occur. So in order to have a production of wave or oscillation, the medium should be elastic. The medium should be elastic. That means it must obey Hooke's law. It must obey Hooke's law. Generally we are writing the restoring force equal to minus kx, where x is the displacement of the particle from displaced position and k is the force constant. The negative sign says that this restoring force is opposite to applied force. So if the medium is elastic, then there is a possibility that you can have an oscillation. If medium is non-elastic or plastic, for example, then Hooke's law do not obey, and in that case particle cannot regain its position once it is displaced, and that's why the oscillation is not possible. And since the oscillations are not possible, waves will not be generated. So in the latter example, when we add a mud into the pond, the property of medium is changed. Then now the property is changing from elastic to inelastic, and that's why this muddy pond is unable to produce oscillations of particle. So waves in general can be produced in elastic medium. In non-elastic or inelastic medium, it is not possible. Second property it must have, it should be inertial. It should be inertial. That means a particle, all particle have some mass. So once you displace it, so according to Newton's law, if it is in motion, it will remain in motion, and if it is in at rest, it will continue to remain rest until and unless some external force applied. That means the medium should be inertial. So if these properties are satisfied by certain medium, then there is a possibility that you can generate waves, because particle will get oscillated. So in the pond example, we have seen that what ripple is generated is essentially a periodic oscillations of medium particle, and because of that, the stone kinetic energy is converted into wave energy, and that wave energy is moving away from point of disturbance with definite speed of wave or velocity of wave. So this is how the waves are generated in particular elastic medium. Now, when we say about waves, we must talk about types of waves. How many types of waves in general or fundamentally we can have? Because we are talking about the oscillations of medium particle. In the case of pond and stone, we are talking about the oscillation of water particle, water molecule. So fundamentally, there are two types of waves, fundamentally. One category is known as transverse wave. ट्रांसवर्स वेव जेने आपणे गुजरातीमां लंबगत तरंग कहीए छीए. अनदर टाइप इज कॉल्ड लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल वेव जेने आपणे गुजरातीमां कहीए छीए संगत तरंग. सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स वेव एंड लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल वेव? Because our prime goal is to understand the acoustic, a physics of sound which we can hear. Light is also an example of wave. So first we'll understand what do we mean by transverse wave and what do we mean by longitudinal wave. These two are the fundamentally different category of waves. In the nature, you will have many types of waves, but all the waves can be classified either transverse or longitudinal. There is no third category exists. So in the transverse wave, if I draw the diagram, then let's say I am showing few water molecule on the surface of pond. Only few. And this horizontal axis is labeled as X. So from the origin of the axis, I can identify the location of each and every particle. X1, X2, X3, these are the location or position of different particles on the surface of pond. And we have considered only few. Now when you throw the stone, what will happen? This particle will displace and it goes at the bottom somewhere. So displacement increases and that's why the restoring force increases, and that's why it comes to momentarily at rest. And since the external force has gone right now, the only acting force is the restoring force, which is proportional to displacement. So it moves towards the initial position. And when it moves towards the initial position, its kinetic energy increases, it accelerates, and when it comes to original position, because of inertia, the motion will overshoot and it go in a upward direction. When it increases in an upward direction, again this position increases from the original position. The restraining force applies. It will try to pull the particle towards the original position, and motion overshoot, then it goes into below side. And that's why the oscillation occurs. This is true for all the particles. This is true for
all the particles.
So one by one, all the particles will set into oscillations.
So when you see the diagram, at any instant, the position
of the particle and the displacement of the particle
will look like this.
So it looks like some waves are generated, sine wave or cosine wave. That means this is a transverse wave. The vibration of particle is in y direction and location is in the x direction. That means wave is moving either from left to right or right to left with certain velocity of wave. So direction of propagation of wave and the direction of vibration of medium particle are perpendicular to each other. Since they are perpendicular to each other, this is called transverse wave. And what are the examples of transverse wave in which the velocity of wave is perpendicular to the vibration of medium particle? This is light wave. So light wave is the example of transverse wave in which what is oscillating? It is electric and magnetic field which is oscillating and which is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of light. So now I will be finishing right now. In the second example, the particle vibrates in the same direction where you have thrown the stone, for example. So vibration is in the x direction and velocity of wave is also in x direction. So both the directions are parallel to each other, vibration of particle and propagation of wave. So this is the example of longitudinal wave. Which type of waves are? In example, if you give the example, which type of longitudinal waves are?
The sound waves are the example of longitudinal wave.
So if you have seen how the waves are generated, what should be the property of medium particle, what are the types of waves? There are two types, transverse and longitudinal. Light is an example of transverse wave, sound is an example of longitudinal wave. So I will be finishing. That is the small introduction part of wave, and that is required to understand the acoustics of physics, sound. Thank you.